You're listening to Why You Suck in Bed on the Riotcast Network, riotcast.com.
What kind of animal?
I don't know. I guess it's a bear, but it doesn't really look like one.
Because you humped it so much?
Yeah, because I humped it some fucking face.
Why You Suck in Bed. I am Dr. Stacy, and I am joined with
Johnny Boy
and TP, and we have a special guest. This is Molly, and Molly is our first audition
candidate. She's on a date with us right now
for Callie's position.
She's behind the red microphone.
She's nervous, and I am totally cool with that because I've been doing this for 2 years almost, and I still get nervous before a show. So she's going to join us, and she's going to show us what she's got, and I think she'll be...
she's taking her clothes off. Cool.
Well, that's part of the candidate.
The haze. And we're going to have her for 2 shows. So welcome, Molly. What would you like to give us a little background? You can tell us as much or as little about you as you'd like.
Well, I'll say something right now. Very, very attractive.
She's very attractive.
It's nice to have 2 attractive women back on the show.
Aww.
And then beautiful, beautiful Jeff.
Fuck you.
Fuck you, Edwin.
Hey, I'm not...
I don't go for your gay shit here. Right?
You do. You.
We finally got 2 chicks, and you're talking about me?
Yeah, let's why are you
on,
just talking over Molly? I mean,
exactly.
You asked for a female.
Holy
She's
shit.
Here.
You're already jumping down my shit. Why don't you calm yourself?
Just bringing vagina back.
Look at his penis. Do you think
look, throw it on
I'm
the table.
I'm waiting for a foot.
It's good looking. There's more of that gay shit for you.
Yeah. Oh, God.
No, yeah, really. Molly is a fan. She is attractive. She's in her 20s, which is, we have a, yeah, do we have anyone else in their 20s at this table?
In my mind, I am.
My Franken-penis.
So she's a breath of fresh air. Now, Molly sent in a audition video. I watched some of it. I didn't watch all of it just because when I watched it, I was actually on a road trip with this guy. And he took the video. He took the phone from me.
Oh, yeah.
And watched the video. And you referenced summer breasts, which was amazing. What were the other ones? Do you remember?
I was just staring at her body. I'm sorry. I got to
be
honest.
Oh, what's up, motherfuckers? And you do have summer breasts. They're out.
They
She's
are
showing
out.
Yours. And I didn't show mine today. See,
you
I
are hiding yours,
I
but
wasn't gonna...
she was thinking. She's coming on the candidate.
She, yes, she came with her summer breasts, and I appreciate that.
Why don't you take your shirt off? And...
We only did that once, and Jeff felt us up.
That's part of the
yep,
game.
Yep, so I got to do it now.
No, we're not doing that again. We're not doing...
It's part of the process.
We're not doing that.
Listen, each of you take a breast and put it into one of his
everything
hands.
Everything that's been done with Callie, I got to do.
Callie showed us her vagina.
Exactly.
She showed us everything.
And I have the dick-smelling mic. It's awesome.
Well, I don't know if you... when we were on Glory Hole, Rob Sprantz, I guess, doesn't disinfect the mics like Jeff does. And she used Franco's mic. And he did go to use it the following show.
Right, and he said it smelled like dicks.
Yes, and he started dry heaving and gagging. And Rob had to clean the mic. So it really is an issue. But Jeff does disinfect, right?
Yes, I do.
Yes, because we've had a lot of people use that mic since Callie's gone, and no one's complained.
Papa Jeff takes care of everybody.
I just have to say, you look pretty similar to what I imagined.
Really?
You look like.
Wow. Oh, wow. See that?
It's and not a bad thing.
Were there any concerns that you had?
How fat am I?
not fat.
You're a gorgeous, gorgeous man.
Here we go again. Get out. Go.
He's in love. When did you become gay?
I'm not Barney.
We
go
bring
away.
A woman in,
it must
and you're
have been
gay.
The trip. It must have been the trip.
And that's why Stacey broke up with you.
Oh.
Yeah, I like her.
That is not why you broke up with me.
We know
but
why.
We're not going to get into
you're
that
a cheater.
Again. All right. Fuck
so,
you. Fuck you. Fuck you and fuck Edwin.
How's your separation going?
It's a mess. But
are you guys seeing lawyers? I mean, are you divorcing? I mean, you are on Match.com, so there must be some movement towards divorce.
Yeah, no, I'm done with the whole thing. And I'm done. It's over.
And how does Claire feel about that?
Listen, I'm not having this discussion.
Why?
Sorry, Claire. I didn't bring it up.
I'm just
because she's probably listening.
We do a weekly check-in of everybody, and I was just wondering how you were doing.
Why don't you ask me how horrible my dating life is?
Okay. Then? How horrible is your
fucking
dating?
Fucking sucks dicks.
Really?
That's implied, isn't it?
Have you had a date since the time that you asked the girl out and spoke to her about masturbating to pasta? Have you had a date since then?
Oh.
that really happened, Mom.
I think that was my last match date, actually.
And how long ago was
that? I haven't been on one in a while.
Really?
Yeah.
How long ago was that?
A couple months ago.
No, so, second date after the pasta story?
Yeah.
So surprising.
Shocking.
No, she called me back. She wanted to set up another date.
Did she?
Yeah.
But you weren't into it?
I wasn't into her, though. She was cool. Don't get me wrong. I mean,
John is so picky.
Yeah. Well.
In fact, just the other day, my friend and I were talking, and she said to me, I cannot believe John is still single. He's so nice. He's so smart. He's attractive. Why is he single?
I hope you're recording all of this.
I didn't say it. She said it.
You want to take clips.
Sound clips.
For her voice saying that shit.
And I said he's so fucking picky.
Fucking sluts.
Oh, you got sound clips. So, is that true? Aren't you too picky?
Listen, I know what I like, and if it's not that, then why would I waste my time? I wasted enough of my time.
Okay.
I mean, that's the bottom line.
Okay.
I just happen to know what I like.
Okay, Jeff, how are you?
Me, I'm the same. You know me.
What's new?
Nothing's new.
I believe you had a show recently.
I had quite a few, yes. The Johnimal was at one of
them. Oh, man, that was an awesome show.
And
I think that's why he loves me, because that was a great show.
Now, the Johnimal showed up. And
yes.
Who else was there?
The infamous Gina was there.
That's right.
Oh. Yeah.
Gina showed up.
I didn't see her because it was so dark.
Oof.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm sorry.
That's racist.
That's racist, yeah. But she's not black. Remember,
she's
I got to pick up
Indian.
The racism because she's...
I didn't
she's
know
West
that.
Indian.
You didn't know she's West
she's
Indian?
She's West Indian.
No, I didn't know that she was at that show.
I didn't know until very late, again, because it was... I'm not saying this to be funny. It was very dark, and I didn't see her, and she was obviously hovering around the crowd in the back. And
she didn't say anything to you? Like,
at one point...
You had sex with her, for Christ's sake. She can't acknowledge you?
That was because she was heading towards me at one point, stopped, did a 180, and went back to where she was sitting. And I was staying in the bathroom, so obviously... She had to go to the bathroom, and she refused to go because I was standing near the bathroom.
But you also hide in the shadows, kind of.
Yeah.
You lurk.
Like,
so we were both kind of lurking in
like
shadows.
Like, we spoke for a little bit before you went on.
And then I just
And then
away.
I didn't know where he went.
I'm so like a ninja.
I went up with a couple people towards the stage, and we were watching the next band. And at one point, I turn around, and there he is right behind me. I was like, oh, shit.
You are your fucking ninja.
I am a ninja, yeah. So I made sure I stood near the bathroom for the rest of the night.
Wait, so why did she come? She clearly still wants your cock.
No, no. The band was after us. She basically sucks all their cocks.
Oh, but she did suck yours.
Metaphorically,
that's so fucked
metaphorically
up.
She sucks their cocks.
Oh.
She treats them like they're huge rock stars, and she has, and their singer is quitting the band and moving to Florida, so she has to see like all their final
what
shows.
What band is it? Can you tell me on air?
They're a tribute to Tool.
Oh, I love them.
You just suck at cock.
that's the way she is. She
they,
really thinks they are Tool.
Fucking married, all of them.
Exactly.
Scandal.
What a whore.
Yeah.
Ho for show.
I'm not saying she actually has sucked their cock. I'm saying she treats them like they really are Tool.
So she loves them.
So.
Okay.
She goes out of her way to see every one of their shows.
Oh, that's exhausting.
So, yeah.
First time I met Gina was the show in Brooklyn.
Mm-hmm.
I was dressed as Sandy.
Yeah, Franco was there.
Franco was dressed as Danny mm-hmm. from Greece, which I know, I've never seen, but that's what Callie said we look like. And
you've never seen Greece?
No,
I was going to say.
Are you out of your mind? Are you serious?
I hate that shit. I hate musicals.
What?
Don't. Don't get me started. Don't get.
This is a classic.
I know. I just couldn't.
Thank you. Are you serious?
And plus, I hate John Travolta with a passion.
But not in that movie, because he's hot as fuck in that movie.
I know.
My head just exploded.
He's very young. It's before he was bloated and scary.
He
and Scientology.
Looks sexy. You know,
regardless of.
And what's her name is hot as hell in that movie. She's beautiful.
Olivia Newton-John.
She's beautiful. Mm-hmm. With those leather pants.
Exactly.
I've seen I've seen that scene and it's hot.
But it's like schoolgirl going to full-on slut.
It's full-on slut.
Badass.
Yes. If I turn into a slut, I get the dude.
Yeah. Awesome story. That is the moral of the story.
All of our young girls.
Everybody should listen to.
Should watch that movie and learn the moral.
So how do you not know every...
No, you don't understand. I don't
You want me to sing Desperately Devoted to you?
No.
Hopelessly.
I don't. Yes, thank you. It's hopelessly. And even I know.
Oh, you know that.
I did know that. I was sitting there like, it's not Desperately.
I just got pwned.
Asshole. I don't like musicals. I fucking hate them. Except I did recently see Once on Broadway. And I did like that.
Hmm. Ironically, that's one I haven't
seen. The lead guy is so hot. It was a pleasure to watch him sing.
Did you pleasure while you watched him?
Almost. And I went with a friend of mine, and she sat there sobbing the whole show. I'm like, she's like, he's just so hot and good.
Now, was she sobbing and touching herself? Because that's fucking awesome. I mean, what? Who said that?
We could, yeah. That would have been nice. Who can resist those succulent melons? Who is I talking to about?
Scarlett Johansson.
Yes.
Oh, right. I love her, too. So anyway, I don't know how we got here.
Greece.
Oh, that was the first time I saw...
Met Gina.
Gina, and she was wearing...
White, all white.
No, it wasn't all white.
It was like
I was
flowery.
With Callie, and Callie is the one that pointed it out. She's like, look at her shoes. And I looked at her shoes, and they were white sandals with the thick, like this high.
I hate that.
Right? Thank you.
Hate
the
that.
Platformy. They were like circa 1984.
They're ugly.
They were so gross, and they were like they were almost like a nursing shoe.
It's like you're not hiding that you're trying to look taller.
Right.
But you're
and
doing
slim
a horrible
your legs.
Job.
Right. And I was like, no, there's no way. This can't happen. And she even said that to you. She said, that was disgusting, those white shoes. So, and you just wanted to suck your cock, so you didn't care.
Yeah, I didn't. I wasn't looking at her feet.
But yeah, who gives a shit about...
We do.
Yes.
Women care.
Women
it says
do
a
care.
Lot.
Guys do not care.
Footwear says a lot about a chick. A lot.
So she wants to look taller. Who gives a shit?
But you can look taller. Like she could
there
have
are
worn a really
more fashionable options.
A hot stiletto. Okay. Yeah, she could have worn
those
like
don't
a
even
wedge.
Make your legs look good because your foot's still flat.
Right. Thank you. A nice like
oh,
wedge
okay.
shoe.
Now I'm getting a picture.
You know what I mean?
They're like Converse, okay. but if the bottom was like five times
yes.
bigger.
Then I'll arc your foot or
anything right.
like
and
that.
They're white, like blinding white. And right. white
it was,
shoes
it was
are
a
hard
contrast
to pull off.
To her skin. That's why they were so white.
God, no.
Stop.
It had nothing to do with her skin. So there's this website called Gamefly.com that
yeah,
has a whole bunch of video games on it.
Yeah.
You're speaking to the choir. That website is amazing.
It's apparently offering an exclusive incentive for Riotcast listeners for a free 15-day two-disc free trial. It's a $22.95 value.
I actually just signed up for that.
Did you?
Yeah. Since the last time we spoke about it, you know, I said I had never actually signed up for it. The site is unbelievable.
So what do you do? Like, you just... is it? I heard it was something like a Netflix for video games.
Yeah, basically. It's real easy. And then I got my first game, like, a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And I've been playing it nonstop. I haven't done anything else.
They offer 8,000 video games for PlayStation, Xbox, Wii, and now your PC.
And when I'm done with it, like, when I beat it, or if the game did suck and I didn't like it, mm-hmm. you just fucking mail it back and you get another one. It's awesome.
Wow. So it's basically a free trial. So what you have to do is you go to the Why You Suck in Bed page through Riotcast.com, click the Gamefly banner, or you can go to Gamefly.com/suck. Is that what it is?
It's suck.
Gamefly.com/suck.
We're a team. We do things together.
There's nothing worse than buying a video game and it sucking. And then you're stuck with it.
It saves you a lot of money.
It saves a shit ton of money. Because, I mean, what can you do with old video games? You trade them in, you get like $2 from them. Gamefly, you play it a while. If you don't like it, you send it back. They send you another one. Biggity bam.
My friend told me that he tried the new Max Payne 3 Ghost Recon and the Special Ops
Max
game.
Max Payne 3 is sick.
Yeah.
Sick game.
And he played it for as long as he wanted for a fraction of the cost for buying it.
I mean, some games you beat real quick, and then, you know, it's like, oh, shit, what do I do with this?
Right.
You know, and you send it back, you get another one. Bang. You like the game a lot, you keep it for a while. You keep it as long as you want.
You keep it, you play it, and you beat it.
Fucking do what you do.
Gameplay.com.
/suck.
Suck. So we have to introduce a new segment.
Now? Okay.
Yeah, we're doing it already.
Why? I have so much to get to.
Because I'm not angry
I
yet.
I have to get you. Oh, all right. Well, let me anger you.
Yes.
Let me anger
great.
You.
I think
it's run-of-the-mill penis. How are the months upon months of masturbation going for you since you haven't been dating?
You're a dick.
How's that going? With the I mean, I'm sure the pasta in
no,
your
no
pantry
pasta.
Are I terrified.
Okay, I bet since talking about it on the show, you've tried it again.
Yeah, totally.
I actually haven't. I really haven't. I've grown past the pasta.
I don't believe you.
What was the last thing you masturbated with that was not
normal?
Normal. Normal, quote unquote.
A plastic bag, I think.
What?
Sans pasta?
Even Jeff went, what?
Yeah, like into
like a lubed in, up.
Like into a bag. Lock? I had nothing around. Yeah, like into a bag. You know, like a sandwich bag.
What are your
just
thoughts?
Into it?
Just blow it into the bag, and then you discard it.
There's like no friction or anything.
Thank
I wasn't
you.
Jerking with it. I just it was like,
oh,
oh,
it was just there to
a
catch
receptor.
It?
Oh,
yeah.
That's not... Exactly. I mean,
it was like a spittoon, basically. Like.
Right. I had nothing. I was like, oh, shit. Oh, fucking.
That's
dang.
A waste of plastic.
You don't care about
the environment.
Condom.
You don't care about
you're not jerking off green, are you?
Asshole.
Next time I'll blow it on the floor. Sorry. I just don't want people coming in with UV lights and finding all my spurts on the floor.
But if they went through your garbage, they'd see plastic bags full of cum.
And then they would have beautiful children because those spermies would produce...
Oh, Jesus.
They would fertilize so many eggs.
Franken babies. We were at a party recently. John and I were at a party. And the masturbation with the pasta came up at the party. And there was a friend of ours
right.
there.
I wonder who brought that up.
Me.
It's a hell of an icebreaker.
And our friend was there with his fiance, and she's a very sweet girl. And she's like almost like a deer in headlights girl. Like she seems very, how do you describe her? Almost like... pure and sweet and
innocent
and she her face when we were talking about you fucking pasta she was like I felt and then I felt like I wanted to take all those words away that I said. I felt so bad for her.
Yeah, well.
And Rob's like, oh my god, like, I can't believe I introduced her to you.
But then that started the comment like, what other guy hasn't stuck their dick in something weird? I mean, everybody.
Nobody else said anything at the party.
Because
most people don't admit it.
That's
right,
true.
Exactly.
You have balls. I'll give you that.
Yeah. You know, nobody admits anything about sex normally.
Exactly.
That's why
why I'm doing this.
Because it's dirty.
Right.
Dirty, dirty.
Everyone
I don't
fucks.
Understand why it's inappropriate to talk about. Boggles my mind.
I mean, if you've heard me, I've gone off on... the judgment we get from the show, from people, and the, you know, people walking around thinking it's, like, scandalous to talk about fucking or
but it's ridiculous. I
naked.
Don't see why we don't talk about it the way we talk about food. Like, oh, I had great rigatoni for dinner last night. I fucked my husband.
Up.
It
he's
was
up.
Awesome.
He's right over, he's right over there.
He's getting turned on.
My hand is slowly slipping down my pants.
So the doctor masturbates with books. Oh, what do you masturbate with?
Actually, the one way that I relate to Callie.
The monkey?
I have a stuffed animal.
Oh. Ooh! What kind of animal?
It's, I don't know, it's, I guess it's a bear.
Okay.
It's but like it doesn't really bear? Look like one.
Because you humped it so much?
Yeah, because I humped it fucking face.
Do you use like... a part, like Callie used the nose because it was harder.
No, not even. It's just like something soft.
Yes.
I guess you
could do it with
anything.
Tore its face off.
But you know what? Like when you masturbate as a woman, you can either
hump it.
Can I say it again? I'm like,
hump.
Do the humpy hump.
You can ball up anything.
Yeah, exactly.
And just rub yourself against
it. I dated
it.
A girl in college who claimed that when she was really, really young, like before sleeping in a bed, like a big person bed, that she would dry hump her Care Bear.
Right, exactly. I think
that's
a lot
normal?
Of little...
Yeah.
I would say I even babysat a little girl that started doing that while I was babysitting.
Really?
Yeah.
It was like 4 years old.
She said that. I was like, fucking bullshit.
No. Mm-hmm.
I would say most girls start out like that.
Holy shit.
Young girls will play with themselves. They will hump things. Yeah. Because think about it. Like, you know, when they discover their clitoris, they go after it.
You don't know what you're doing. You just know it feels awesome.
It's not like they that you know you're
so
having...
So it actually, like, works back then?
Yeah.
Because, I mean, for dudes, it's a little different. I mean, us, like, it's like when we're 12 or 13, it's like, whoa, what's going on down there?
It's different
it's
for girls.
Like that.
And then the first time it spurts, you're like, what's this shit? What's going on?
You know, this is interesting because I don't know that anyone really talks about this. But girls, it's kind of like we always know it feels good.
Yeah, I honestly can't remember the first time.
Yeah, I always knew.
I do remember back when I was like watching Power Rangers. I must have been like 4 years old doing it since then.
Yeah,
so.
Me too.
Like touching yourself?
Yeah.
Yeah, and humping things. And
yeah, having an orgasm, yeah.
This is fucking mind-blowing.
No. Really?
Guys don't realize this.
I know. Just like they don't know about the period. They think they know, but they don't
know.
They
do not know.
This is the argument that I...
choose not to know about that.
This is the argument that I had in college. Like, how would we possibly know this stuff?
No, we're not blaming you.
No.
You just don't know. Unless...
Well, health class, like in high
school.
Yeah. In health class, they don't really talk about that.
No, when I lived
in...
In
college, human sexuality, they spoke about
it. When I lived in a dorm, they would have, like, speakers come in and speak about, you know, random shit all the time. Mm-hmm. And one time, I'll never forget, my sophomore year, they had someone come in to speak about birth control. Mm-hmm. And it was girls only. And I was, at the time, I didn't really give a shit, but I was just being a dick.
This is in college?
Yeah. And I went to the RA and I was like, I want to go. Why can't I go?
That's ridiculous.
I didn't
really want to go, but I was like, you know, and this is a true story. Like, I almost started eating birth control one time because I thought they were breath mints. Like, it was one of those dispensers, you know, the ones that you turn?
Wait.
You weren't thrown off by the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday?
It was a circular thing.
A mint for every day.
When your breath stinks on Monday.
It was a circular thing, and
I'm well aware of what a birth control.
When I turned it, the thing popped out.
Yes.
And I was like, "Woo, candy!"
Where'd you find
that dispenser? You thought
I started spinning.
Where'd you find that?
It was on her.
Who's her?
It was a girl I was hooking up with. It was on her dresser next to her bed.
Shit. Wait. So you were at least 18.
I was my sophomore year, so I had to be
in
at
college.
Least 18. Yeah. I never had hooked up with a girl. I had never hooked up with a girl up to that point who was on birth control.
It's interesting. Fucking fat. I have to really school you. I have to really, because there's a lot you probably don't know.
I've learned a little bit since then, but
a little.
Wow.
But that's
you know that they're not mints.
Yes.
Right. Well, as I started to put it in my mouth, she was like, "What the fuck are you doing?" And I was like, "I don't know." When I turned this, the candy.
And
popped
what did she witness this?
Yes. That's,
did she ever hook up with you again?
Good. Because
she did, and she peed the bed one time.
Okay, you gotta tell us.
We came home drunk to her place, and she peed the bed. She pissed the bed.
Spood. See, I feel like that's more common than people speak about. You know, I think that happens, and I also think a lot of girls get their period while hooking up, and they don't talk about it. I think
that yes, peeing, no.
I think when you're really shit-faced, though.
What, your period
pops out? I've never done it.
I've never peed the bed.
No, peed the bed. I've never done it.
But yes, okay. It happens more than people talk about.
Yeah, Callie did.
But not that much.
Callie peed on a guy's foot while giving him a blowjob.
That she talked about.
Right?
Yep.
It slips out.
No, she
most
was,
people would not disclose stories like that.
That was insane. She told a story for listeners that didn't hear this episode. She was blowing a guy and she was so drunk that, you know, like when you're drunk, obviously you're not rational.
You can't multitask.
She's like, "I'll just let a little pee out to get rid of the pressure so I could finish the blowjob." And she just pissed all over the place. And the guy's like, "What the fuck are you doing?"
But she was probably in position too, like squatting down.
Yeah, her bladder was like release.
it was the damn release.
Wow. All right. So she stopped you from eating her birth control.
Well, but that's my point. Like, how am I supposed to know that even when there are people coming in to speak about it, it's like this taboo.
Yeah.
That, you know, and the ultimate answer was because you can't.
I don't
agree with them.
I don't agree with that.
And
at
it
all.
Wasn't like a Catholic school or it was a Sunni school.
I guess they just assume guys don't need to know. But
then we get blamed when you get knocked
when
up.
You almost
it's like it's
eat
my
it.
Fault.
Mm-hmm. Guys, how are you supposed to know? But guys do need to know because birth control, I mean, they must have talked about condoms at that seminar, right?
That was a separate seminar they had about condoms. Because they would give those out in the...
So it was birth control pills they spoke about?
It was... The topic was birth control. They had different topics
that condoms speakers... Condoms they gave out like in a t-shirt shooter, like the big area. Yeah, they just...
No, they had them at the health office, and you can go down and get free condoms.
Right.
And I love those, because they were the ones that, the black ones, mm-hmm. that make your dick black.
The tuxedo ones. I love fancy occasions.
I loved walking around being
black
like, look,
is very slimming.
I have a black penis. I thought it was funny.
Did it make your dick look thinner than it actually is?
TP probably uses those exclusively.
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
Magnums, you got it, babe.
Black
magnums.
Yeah.
Babe. Never seen the sun.
Babe, I got the condoms, babe.
Babe. All right, are you riled up?
All right, yeah. You can. which one do you want? Do you want the angry one? Do you want the angry? Do you want the angry one?
Well, let me play your theme song now.
Right. That's supposed to get you crazy.
Oh, fucking pump me up. Mm-hmm. You're going to bring out the John Mulligan.
If you're paying for a fucking website, why would you not put a real picture of yourself? I don't want to date your fucking dog.
Why don't you put your fucking ass to sleep?
Fuck Match.com. Fuck Match. Fuck Match.com.
Gonna bring out the John Mulligan. You're gonna bring out the John Mulligan. You're gonna bring out the John Mulligan.
I don't remember saying any of that.
You're gonna bring out the John Mulligan.
Blind rage.
Fuck that guy.
Fucking awesome.
Sluts. Rocking.
Fucking sluts.
Now, gotta add that in. Jeffrey Edwin would not approve of that.
No.
Who? Exactly. Go on.
I fucking love that shit. That was awesome. All right. Well, my rant this time. Sorry, ladies. But even on my way here, and you've heard this rant multiple times, especially on the trip that we took the other day. Females should not be allowed to fucking drive. I'm sorry.
I knew this was coming.
You should not be allowed to fucking drive.
1961?
Stop pounding the table.
Every time... Listen, these are some ways that you know that when you're in traffic or you're driving, that you're behind a female that's driving a car.
Here we go.
All right, the first thing is very simple. If they're driving an Eclipse or a fucking Celica, immediately you know that it has to be a female.
Do people still have Eclipses?
Yes. I have one.
Had
past tense.
It's so true. Or like a huge ass SUV, and they drive like you drive with fucking texting with one hand, with a coffee culotta in the other hand. Big
I don't
fucking,
drink culottes.
Big fucking sunglasses on
I
your
don't
face.
Wear big sunglasses, except recently
with like a foot hanging out the window.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's me.
Fucking swerving in and out of traffic.
Hollis drives.
Yeah.
If you're in the left lane. And there's someone going 10 below the speed limit with two car lengths in front of them, it's a female. Every fucking time. You should not be allowed to drive in the left lane. Done. That's a dude lane.
Where?
Dude lane.
Dude.
Wow.
That's where
they
fast.
Should put that on
they
the
should
highway.
Just paint a giant penis in the left
Seriously.
Lane.
Seriously.
Yeah. Yes. Instead of the diamond for
you
HOV.
Know what?
What about lesbians?
If you want to drive slow.
Lesbians.
I don't know about lesbians.
Well, you better go do some field research, because I think
you know what? I would
that
think
they probably drive more dude-like.
I Agreed. Bet you they do. I would agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
I would agree with
actually,
that.
Actually, I have evidence of that.
Oh, see?
Yeah.
See? We actually
My lesbian friend drives like a fucking asshole.
So it's fine.
If you get to a stop sign, or you're coming to a stop sign, and the person starts braking for the stop sign half a block before the fucking stop sign, it's definitely a female. And then when she gets to the stop sign, she has to wait to get waved before she goes. Like, there are stop sign rules and etiquettes. If someone else pulls before you, they go first. If you pull up before them, then you go.
And what if you pull up at the same time? Do you know the rule?
Then someone waves the other
no,
person.
No, that's not the rule.
I don't give a shit.
No, I give
that's
a shit with the rules.
Do it in
there
real
are
life.
Traffic
that's
rules that you
life.
Need to follow.
That's real life.
And if you pull up at a stop sign at the same time, the person to the right goes first.
You know what? I let the person go anyway. Well, because I'm a fucking gentleman.
Yeah, but men just ignore the rules
that's
of
right.
the road.
I'm a
thank
gentleman.
Thank you. Men do whatever the
that's
fuck they
that's why you
want.
Think that women it's, are such bad fucking drivers.
But that's,
yeah.
that's normal. Because
you have a cock. You don't have to listen to the rules.
It's not. That's not a fucking enforced rule. That's. It's just like
it's
road
in the manual.
It's
that was
road
on
etiquette.
My fucking permit.
Has anyone, ever gotten pulled over because they let someone go that was on their left
no,
side or something?
Cops are fucking lazy.
I don't
because
know.
Cops are dudes and they know how to fucking drive.
Oh, not what? All of them.
I have a girlfriend that's in the NYPD.
Well, she doesn't pull anyone over. Because she shouldn't be in a car anyway.
How many four-way
right, moving
stops
on.
Do you see in New York City?
That's right.
Moving on. You pull up to a stop sign, and the woman waits to get waved from someone before she... There are rules!
Yeah, rules that you just said you don't follow because you have a cock.
Okay, but I don't sit there for 20 minutes and wait for someone to tell me to go. Okay. It's not a stoplight.
She had an important text. Okay.
Yeah. It's not a stoplight.
Oh, okay.
Or how about making a right-hand turn from the center lane? Always a woman.
No.
Always.
I've seen dudes
every
do that.
Fucking
I've seen
time.
Impatient men. Impatient
always.
Men
yeah.
who think that they know better cut off a chick mm-hmm. from the middle lane.
Or I had one. A girl put on her left signal.
To go right.
And went right into the back of my car.
All right.
The dent. That car
this
outside.
This is anecdotal.
Yes. And I've been in accidents. And every accident I've ever been in has involved a dude. A dude.
And
one
it's
guy,
probably your fault.
No, it wasn't.
No.
One guy.
You must be the common denominator.
I was driving down the road, and one guy pulled over with a bunch of his friends and went to, and did a U-turn into the side of my car. He didn't look.
Yep.
He just went, right in my car.
And I
right
stopped at a stop sign right off an exit, and this guy just fucking rear-ended me.
See? Dude.
Clearly not my fault. And it was a guy.
Because they're
a Mercedes,
impatient and angry. Thankfully. Like you.
Or another thing, you don't have to come to a full stop before you make a fucking right-hand turn.
Yes, you do.
You, what? You
the rules don't apply to you.
What are you talking about? If you're no, bullshit. If you're making, if you're in a right-hand lane and you're making a right-hand turn, you do not have to come to a full stop before you make the right-hand
on
turn.
On a green light?
Yes, on
oh.
a fucking green
okay.
light.
Okay, all right. I thought you meant on a red. I apologize.
And when you're making a left, make the fucking left. You don't have to wait for every person to go first.
You know what bothers me? That women, I will admit this one thing that women do.
Drive like fucking old people.
No, if they're...
That's what they do.
If they're in a left-hand lane and there's a left-hand turn signal...
They never go. Never go.
But also a green light. Like, you know, like there's a left turn, you go, and then it turns just steady green.
Mm-hmm.
You could still proceed forward and make
yeah.
the left.
They
will
wait
not...
at the line.
They'll wait at the line until the arrow comes. I hate that.
Agreed.
Annoying. And it's usually a woman.
The only time that I've ever been wrong where I've been like, that's definitely a woman, is if it's an old dude. Like women and old dude, like the dude that has like the huge blocker glasses on driving the Buick or the town car.
Yeah.
That guy drives the same as you.
What?
Now, if you're behind...
Don't be an asshole.
If you're behind a really old woman, forget about it. You might as well... She might as well have her hazards on.
You
I
know
mean,
what?
You're just...
If
you're
I
not
drive so poorly,
anywhere.
Then why are you always with me? Why do you always let me drive
yeah,
to places?
Did you drive on this road trip
no.
recently?
No, she usually does drive places. Mm. I will give you that. And it's because, you know what? If you offer the drive, I'm not going to fucking turn it down. Even though it might kill me.
Well,
you know what? Drinking might kill me. I still fucking do that.
You drive like a fucking asshole. Because I'm driven with you. And first of all, he takes his seat and he leans it all the way back.
I'm comfortable.
Superman.
And he drives with his arm completely extended. And he is always at least 30 miles per hour over the speed limit.
And that's why I get places on time, unlike you. What?
And you weave. You're a weaver. You weave.
You know what else I do? if someone's driving slow in the left lane, I will ride their fucking ass because your ass should not
be
in my lane.
Which is against the rules.
I don't give a fuck. You should not be driving 10 below the speed limit
on
a goddamn highway.
I'd fucking die on the road.
Yes.
I've been told I drive like a grandma, so I can't contribute.
It's now you've offended our guests.
So drive in the right lane. That's all
I'm
saying.
I do.
Then that's fine. I have no problems
Stop
with
it.
That.
Stop it.
Don't be in my lane.
Stop it.
Some people like to drive slow. Hell, if I don't have my glasses on, then I'll drive slow.
If you met a girl from Match.com and you loved everything about her, but she drove like she was a horrible driver.
Most women are, so that wouldn't be, that would never.
You're an asshole.
That would never be a deal breaker. And you know what? Listen. And I don't want anyone to get the wrong impression. I love you women. I love you. Love you.
Only if you got big boobs.
And you know what? If you didn't have these differences from us, then, you know.
There'd be no point in living.
That was condescending.
There'd be no point in loving
you. You're such a dick. I don't believe a word you're saying right now. You hate women. I think you're like a closeted gay man.
Oh, my God.
You're in love with
TP. You know what? It would be so much easier if that was true because women are so fucking crazy.
Don't promote it, please.
Can you just wait
Don't.
Wait on the crazy rant for another show.
I think guys project.
Yes, I agree. Guys are pretty fucking crazy. Look at my ex-boyfriends.
They're
all insane.
That's not true. I am not insane.
They're like, oh, women are so fucking jealous.
Excuse me. What? I am not insane.
A little bit, in the words of Robert De Niro.
Yeah, a little bit.
You're going to have to play that music again.
Let's go to...
I'm on crazy pills, so I can't fight this.
Let's go to listener email. Here we go.
Okay, I'll try as a part of
your audition.
Oh, shit.
It's time to answer your email.
Oh, God.
It's time to answer your emails.
And here we go.
Bravo. See, very good.
I like her voice. It's a little deeper and like smoother than yours.
Don't let the voice
fool you.
She does have a nice deep voice.
And I'm not taking anything away from your voice.
It's okay.
Because you have
I can't even fake a girly voice. I just can't.
No, but that's a very sultry, sexy voice.
It is.
But it's like unique. People are like, why is your voice so deep?
Yeah, I like it.
I don't think it's deep, though.
It's not mannish.
I think, to myself, I hear it as really deep, like deeper than a guy's voice.
Everyone hates their own voice. Yep. Everyone. I hate my voice.
Very true. I hate my voice.
TP.
Anyway, we should have played this email before his rant.
Yes, I know. To get him fired up.
I didn't think I had the authority to suggest this.
You do. As long as you're on here, you can just take over Callie's role.
Do whatever the hell you want.
Just don't interrupt everyone like Callie did.
I can edit all this shit out.
And go like this. I stink. Ugh. I stink. I smell. I didn't put deodorant on.
Do you guys have any paper towels?
Do you want me to look at your lips, see if they're drooping?
Maybe later.
Off.
No, we don't need to see vagina today. Okay.
Speak for yourself.
There's never not a good time to see vagina.
I have an email from Edwin. Chef.
I'm in my happy place. Go ahead.
The subject is, okay, this went too far. I'm very disappointed in Jeff insulting my sexuality. Isn't that cause for a lawsuit?
Really?
Anyway, this is going too far. My comments have not been insulting nor demeaning towards you. They have been merely honest opinions. No hard feelings, though. I understand you guys are entertainers.
Go back a few emails where he said, oh, so it was Jeff who wrote that stupid fucking song.
Mm-hmm.
That's insulting, you piece of shit.
I understand. You guys are entertainers, and it's just a show.
It's just a joke, you stupid motherfucker.
Your
See,
Zen music is so, like, ironic right now, because...
That's the point, you see.
No.
I'm doing a bit. Just like Edwin doesn't get the irony of it all.
I understand you guys are entertainers. You shouldn't be too harsh.
He doesn't understand. That's
too harsh on your comments. Neither should you insult race or sexual orientation. My mail was never intended to insult anyone. I truly apologize if it went too far. You don't have to read this. I only told you who I was because you guys asked who I was.
We don't have to read this, but we will.
Of course I will.
Why the fuck wouldn't we read this?
Right, right. Any responses? Do it. Do it.
You want me to say it?
Yeah, I want you to say it.
But my Zen music, you know? I mean,
just say it.
I'm not your little monkey, you know? I'm not your little fucking clown.
Angry Jeff. Angry Jeff. Come on. Fuck you, Edwin.
Why doesn't Jeff have a rant segment?
I know. Because he's in charge of the music. And if I could compose music, I would. But
yeah, he's... Yeah.
You should have a segment.
Listen, the bottom line is he's fucking...
I used to have a segment on the first two episodes. Didn't go well.
What was it?
It was the TP's tip, remember?
Oh,
that's...
Just the tip.
That's old school.
Just the tip. Yeah, that's right. Oh, man.
TP's tip.
Yeah. And Callie made fun of the music I wrote.
Oh, we should bring that back.
We should bring it back old school.
No.
Do
I
you
had,
have
I
it?
Had nothing good to say.
Oh, stop.
I'm good lurking
Everyone
in the
Everyone loves when you talk. Everyone loves when you talk. All right, so we have an email from Spy Archive. What? Jeff loves her.
I love her.
Morning, Dr. Stacy. I'd love to respond to Edwin, if that's all right with you. I wanted to send this in just to let you know at least one of your fans dislikes him, and that is putting it mildly. Edwin, you self-entitled sack of shit.
At least two, by the way.
I'm so glad you think you're a musician, just like every other person who owns an instrument. Not really, I don't care. I'm so glad you don't appreciate TP or John. Not really, I like TP and John. I'm quite interested in how you decided TP isn't a real musician. Not really, you're wrong. Most of all, I really appreciate your contribution to the podcast. Not really. You sound like someone who finally found a platform where you can spread your butt hurt through mass media. We're all entitled to our own opinions. But if you're going to act like a snob and criticize the show, don't get upset if no one gives two shits, especially the hosts. You don't like TP. I don't like you. Circle of free speech. You sound like a snide little weasel who feels he should be more appreciated for his self-taught, quote, genius. Aw, not a single person Googled you, except you, apparently. Maybe your big break will come soon. Maybe you missed it when you didn't submit a sample of your music to the podcast. But let's be honest, Edwin, you never would have sent anything because you're not that good. You don't have the balls, or you can't take the criticism.
Damn.
Jesus
Christ.
And she goes on.
Holy shit.
I dislike the term hater, Edwin, but you really do fit the label. You're a coward talking smack from the sidelines where you belong.
Wow.
Because your talent won't get you any further than that. To the hosts of Why You Suck in Bed, I've been listening to the Glory Hole Riotcast Network since the beginning. Thanks for the weekly entertainment. I miss Callie and her wandering stream of consciousness, but I think TP and John are more than making up for her in her absence. Sorry if J-O-H-N is J-O-N. Thanks again, Spy Archive.
I'm really happy the longest email ever read was that.
It's amazing. Do you have a boner right now, TP?
Yeah.
You love her.
I have such Twitter lust for her, and I want to marry her right now.
Wow.
That's amazing, right?
This show just got very dark.
when it centers on me, you see, it gets dark.
I love
That's why I should not have a segment.
We went from a rant to that.
I love the controversy. I
Holy
love it.
Holy shit, dude.
I love it. So I'm going to just save the rest of the emails for our next show. Since we don't... You know what I think? We need to find a punishment for our audience again. Since they... The angry bird. Here we go.
I love this beat.
You better send in some fucking emails, everybody. Or else you're going to get angry bird. It's coming back on in the flesh.
Just...
I actually had an Angry Bird-esque bone to pick.
Okay. Oh!
Not gonna lie.
Let's hear it.
I would love to hear that.
Okay.
Does Angry Bird listen?
No.
Thank goodness.
So, too busy being angry.
A couple episodes back, you guys talked about how bisexual men don't exist, and there's actually a scientific study disproving that.
Okay. Who said they don't exist? Was it me?
Yeah, I think
really?
Both of you did. And I think that's a stereotype.
I always thought, maybe I did, because I have a friend that claimed he was bisexual.
Right. No, no. Callie was talking about talking about the gay men they were hanging out with, saying that bi men are actually closeted.
Right, homosexual. Right. Okay.
Yeah.
So are you referring to the study about there were PET scans done on the brain? Or because I know
No,
there was
I think it was electrodes attached somewhere that like tracked erections and... Yeah.
Okay.
And they actually used...
What gives you an erection?
Okay, so they took men that I think had been in at least a 2-month-long romantic relationship with someone of each sex.
Okay.
And then had them watch same-sex porn, and only the people who self-identified as bisexual and had those relationships actually got aroused by both.
I like it.
Hmm.
Now, I might have said that bisexual doesn't exist, but I've also said, I contradict myself apparently, but I do believe that sexuality is a continuum.
So do I.
I really do, because, and this is a terrible example, forgive me.
I don't believe in lesbians.
But we'll get into that this fucking day. We had a fight on our road trip.
No, that's the same thing as denying that bisexuals
right.
exist.
I don't want to get into
just,
that.
We'll do that another time, but you're so wrong. So,
because everybody needs dick.
Like,
that's just it.
There are a ton of women who have been married to men, have had children, and claim that they've had happy marriages. And then they, you know, they're in their 60s, and they say they identify as lesbian.
But that's the thing. This study was talking about men, because things just work differently for women.
Okay. But what I'm saying is, like, the continuum aspect is these, they do work differently for men. But, because with women, though, I really think that you can go from being identified as a straight woman to another point in your life, identify as a lesbian woman.
I
love vagina. Or to another point in your life, identify as bisexual. And I think Callie is the perfect example of the female part of that.
I disagree. Mm.
You don't think Callie's a bisexual? Because I seriously do.
I think Callie needs dick, and when it comes down to it, she's straight. That's it.
I don't think so.
You think every woman needs dick?
Yes.
But she loves pussy.
Yeah, she loves. Thank you. Molly set it up for you.
I'm
you are the monkey.
Monkey.
You are the monkey. And you have the sound effects at your fingertips.
That's like a hobby.
When you point at me, I'm not going to do it.
Do it.
The rug munching is a hobby. It's something.
The rug munching?
I don't think so.
She's into it right now. But
for the record,
she fucking wants to drink breast milk.
She does. And
yes,
by the way,
it's because she's an experiment. She loves to like do all kinds of like really explore sexuality.
But I have to be honest with you. I identify as a straight woman. I have no desire to lick pussy at this point in my life.
But
it
women
could
are beautiful.
Change.
Good
but
point.
Women are beautiful, and it, to some extent,
women are beautiful.
You're attracted to women to some extent,
yes,
because they are beautiful.
But I don't want to lick their pussy.
But then there are people like Stacey, and then there are people like me. I've been straight. I've never hooked up with a girl. I have a date with a girl tomorrow.
Oh, we're gonna have to talk about that.
Yes.
Okay. See, it changes
because
though.
I could see myself doing that.
Right.
And I want to see if that's something I'm
right.
into.
Can I see you do that?
Can we follow you with cameras?
It's part of the audition process.
Girl on the street.
Can we mic you up?
No, but honestly,
in addition to the blindfold, I have to go with you.
I do see that as a continuum. And I can't say, in all fairness, I can't say that one day I won't be with a woman. Because you should never say never. You
mm-hmm.
never fucking know. And I can only speak for myself. Men, I do believe society puts a lot of demands on them where they're not as in touch with their sexuality as women. They don't feel comfortable saying, I can never say I won't be with a dude.
Mm-hmm.
I truly believe that. I think that there's, from a psychologist's point of view, I think that there's so much repression and denial involved because of the way that men are raised and the way that the culture has conditioned them.
Yeah.
That's what I think.
We suddenly just got too smart for me and my brain.
But this is the damaging part, because I was actually going to send this in as my audition video. I was hooking up with a guy about a year-ish ago, and right before he's about to put his cock in me, he was like, I've never told anyone this, and this is like the worst moment of my life, but I think I'm not into girls.
Oh, what the fuck?
Yes.
Of all time.
Yes. Yes. We were like full on fooling around.
That's a pickle.
Around.
That had to be.
That is a pickle.
That had to hurt you. That's
what
like,
did
that's,
you do?
That's
okay.
Like, whoa.
Okay, but then it turned from sexy to like cry fest, am I gay, blah, blah, blah. A year later, we just recently reconnected. He told me he's been fucking girls for the last year. And it's because he doesn't believe that bisexuality exists.
Oh, that's sad.
Exactly.
That's sad.
So this stigma needs to go away because he doesn't. He's like, I don't understand. I'm attracted to you.
Right.
But I think I'm also into guys.
Aww.
I'm like, well, you can have both.
You can. And my friend is bisexual, and he's been telling me he's bisexual. And I have to be honest, for a long time, I told him, bullshit, you're gay. He's like, no. He said, you don't understand. There are certain women I get aroused for.
Mm-hmm.
He said, but I tend to have sex with men. He said, but I can't say that I'm not attracted. Well, no, he does. But he says the majority of people he has sex with are men. Like, he'll go out on a date with a girl every few years. Right. Or have sex with a girl.
So but that's the continuum.
The majority
that means
of his
he's
time.
Mostly gay.
Mostly
but
gay. But he identifies as bisexual. He identifies by. Because he right. said, "If I can't tell him. You, a woman's not going to walk through the door and I'm not going to be wanting her.
Because he needs dick.
So you need so, dick too.
Yeah, exactly.
I got my own Franken dick. And that's enough.
Oh, so
that's,
does he then.
John that's thinks enough. Every woman so needs dick.
Everybody needs clause. Dick.
No, now his theory is that everyone. Everyone. Male or female needs. Yeah.
He said he
including your own.
Most dudes have your own dicks, and that's enough.
So you're saying this guy doesn't have a dick?
It's not enough for him. He needs more.
Oh,
Jesus!
There's
Christ.
A threshold of dick.
He needs additional dick.
He believes yes. everyone needs dick, and everyone. That men have a dick, and some need more dick. But he said he can understand homosexual men more than he can understand homosexual women. Right? Am I quoting you correctly?
See, that is. Problem.
And
I'm also being a dickhead, and I'm being and I'm being a devil's advocate. So don't.
See, I need a fucking
please
rant section.
don't send me hate mail. I'm not that much.
John
of a
really isn't. He isn't a homophober at all. Homophober. Did I say that?
I think you just add something to the lexicon. That was cool.
He's not. He's not a homophobe.
I lived with him.
I mean, I'd be surprised if you didn't get hate mail about that yeah. segment because.
But no, I'll keep
honest...
getting hate mail from Edwin.
only you get the hate mail.
It's an honest discussion. And yeah. it has to be a discussion because I think we all have ideas about sexuality. And again, my ideas change from year to year. The more I experience in life.
Well, that's because you're a woman and women are fickle. What?
How about
again with the generalization.
How about that we're open to evolution, like evolving our minds and our souls?
It's because you're a beautiful, beautiful person.
Oh, shut up. All right, we're going to go to Stacey's shit. I have some really interesting shit.
Kick it, Kanye.
Are you going to sexy talk? Anybody? Jeff?
Yeah.
Bisexuals.
Everyone needs a dick. A cock.
Everyone needs some cock.
Cock. I miss the way Callie says cock.
Because she emphasizes the C.
Cock.
I both really want to imitate some of the sound bits.
You should.
I love pussy.
I love pussy. Kick it, Kanye.
Big black cock.
Slapping it around. Flapping
slap
in
the face.
She was a maniac. Is a maniac. She's not dead.
Currently a maniac.
She's not dead.
Are you sure?
Are you eulogized?
Is
she
dead? Is she going to beat me up?
No. She's honestly, if she were here, she'd love you.
We made Molly eat some of her flesh to be on the show. To join the cult.
We hazed her. All right, this one's for John.
What?
I have an article that I found. You probably know about it. You know the guy, and I don't want to hear it, people. I'm just referencing something that happened. The guy that shot everyone up in Colorado in the Batman
yeah.
movie theater.
So why is this for me?
Oh, God. He had a Match.com profile.
Oh, God.
Fuck Match.com. Fuck Match.com.
Did you know that?
I did not know that. That's fucking ridiculous.
Match.com spokesman Matthew Traub on Tuesday confirmed reports on TMZ.com and elsewhere that the profile was posted before the movie theater massacre. He'd not comment on whether Match.com believes he actually posted the profile, but it included the question, "Will you visit me in prison?" and said, "I spend a lot of time thinking about the future. Mind equals blown." The profile showed a man whose hair is reddish-orange, similar to Holmes' hair when he appeared in court on Monday. The profile also said, "The first thing people usually notice about me are my soul-penetrating eyes." Whoa, that's deep.
This is clearly fake.
Yeah, that's
are you kidding me?
That's so fucked up.
That's not real.
But it was
what
posted.
News source is this from?
This is the Huffington Post. But it was posted before the massacre.
Oh, okay.
I mean, if it was after, I'd be like, okay.
Yeah, okay.
But it was before. Guy's fucked.
Interesting.
I mean, I don't know if he posted it. Why, like, just as something else we could report.
Could you imagine
on.
If you were one of the people that came up as this match?
99%.
Right, 99%
oh
match.
Oh, my God. All right, here's a great one.
Sorry.
It's okay. No problem.
Kick,
no.
save, and abuse.
Don't worry, they're empty. Fucking chug them.
Sex doll saved from drowning by 18 cops.
Oh, I heard about this.
This is awesome. 18 cops in China's Shandong province.
Of course!
Dong.
worked together to save a sex doll they thought was a drowning woman. They responded to a report that there was a lady in distress in one of the rivers. They worked frantically for nearly an hour to rescue the lady.
How does it take that long?
It took more than 40 minutes for the officers were able to recover the pleasure toy.
Because she wasn't cooperating.
Well, she was laying lifeless.
Of course they were having their way with her.
Attracted a crowd of 1,000 curious, excited, and anxious spectators to the scene. Here's a picture.
How does it take an hour?
Look
to
what
get
region
something?
Is like beaten to death.
Oh my God, her vagina is
exactly.
Inflated.
That's why it took so long.
But the boobies survived.
Yeah, her tits are the only thing keeping her.
They're
up.
All inflated.
They all fucked her.
Exactly.
How else does it take an hour?
The Shandong region. Of course they fucked her.
The Shandong region is an important center for producing sex toys in China and across the globe. So they're used to sex toys. That's what they do.
So the fact that they didn't recognize their own handiwork is fucking ridiculous.
That's weird. It's weird. I love this one. There is something on the market called an anti-adultery ring. Inside the wedding ring, it has the words married on it. So it imprints it in the person's finger. So if a dude takes his ring off before he goes into a bar, it still has an imprint of married his skin.
Yeah, but that would wear off after a while.
Yeah, I just don't think that would work physically.
It has to be worn for a while. It's $550, and it's sold on the cheeky.
So the more adulterous he is, the less it works because he's taking it off all the time.
Exactly.
So Amazon doesn't sell it?
And you'd have to be really
Amazon
dumb.
Sells everything.
Yeah, I'm sure Amazon. Should I look it up? See?
I'm just wondering if our sponsor, Amazon.com, sells these things.
Clever.
I love Amazon. I order everything on Amazon.
Mm-hmm.
Books, movies.
Vibrators.
Do they have those?
Yep.
I bet you
everything,
and I bet you they're cheap too.
There's nothing they don't have.
They're amazing. They really are. They're the best. They're the best website.
I order all my CDs and DVDs through there.
If you could have one website besides Riotcast.com,
it would
you
be
should
Amazon.
Have Amazon.
Yeah,
agreed.
So a great way for you guys to help support Riotcast and Why You Suck in Bed is to order your Amazon products through our Riotcast page. So how you do that is, you go on riotcast.com, you click on the Why You Suck in Bed page, and then you click on the Amazon button and shop away like you normally do. So it's just one extra step. You just click on the Why You Suck in Bed page, and you start ordering.
And they even have pasta.
They have pasta for you, John.
Amazing.
Do it. Daddy needs to buy a Lamborghini.
There's no cost to you, and Amazon has some great pricing options for things from electrics, apparel, computers, books, DVDs, groceries, and more.
I don't know anything, but I do know that when I'm going to order my stuff, I always order it through Amazon, and I get it like 2 days later.
Yeah.
They always give you like a five-day thing. It never comes that late. It always comes way before you expect it.
Absolutely. So help support Why You Suck in Bed. Go to the riotcast.com, click Why You Suck in Bed, click the Amazon button, and order away. A timely article. We're going to talk about sex in Olympic Village. Mm. Now, I have to say, there are...
So, Olympic sex?
A ton of young, in-shape, hot athletes.
Have you seen Ryan Lochte?
Oh, perfection.
He's a fucking Greek sex god.
He's perfect.
Oh, my God.
He's perfect. And they're not banging like animals.
They have to be.
They are.
If you're listening, Ryan...
Molly's available.
Come fuck me.
So, this is actually funny. There's a ton of shenanigans going on in the living quarters.
Obviously.
In the Olympic Village. U.S. women's soccer star Hope Solo recently dished about serious partying at the Beijing Games. And some newly arrived athletes say they can hardly wait for the fun to begin. They say that the Olympics is the height of your career, so you might as well do some things you don't usually do. Threesomes. Sex is common at the Olympics. It's necessary. It's natural. If you're going to be healthy, why not make sex?
It
said a Brazilian.
Let's make lots of sex.
Ivory Coast swimmer Kusai Brow was one of the youngest competitors in Beijing at 16, but he's all grown up now, and he's ready for some Olympic love. He said, in 2008, I was so young and so shy, so I didn't interact with women. But now I'm a big man, so I can try, and I will try.
I smell gangbang.
Is he 12? Now I'm a big...
Well, he doesn't speak English as in his first language, so...
So it's
I bet the basketball players are fucking, like, the 4'2"
gymnasts.
Yeah.
Flipping them around.
They're the fun ones.
Thousands of free condoms are going to be available. Organizers have heard enough about village antics from previous games to know that there's going to be a heavy demand for contraception.
Will they be the same colors as the rings?
You should hang the used condoms up in the shape of the ring.
I really need to bang you.
They're banging on the grass and in between the buildings, according to ESPN.
Why don't they just go to their rooms?
I don't know. It's interesting.
Too many people. They want privacy.
Now, wait, hold on. You said village? They have a village?
Yes.
Of, where is this village?
You want to go?
Is it like the Smurf village that you have to find it? It's a hidden place?
No, the athletes, it's like in college. It's like a...
Gargamel?
It's like dorms. Yeah. They all stay together and they eat together.
For sexy athletes.
Yeah.
So it's like a hotel of them or something?
Well, like little houses and like I think different teams.
I think each country is it has like, their own...
Is it like the Hunger Games where there's like this own little village somewhere of no, champions?
It's like, you know...
Did I just reference something no one knows about it?
Yes. Do not get the
Yeah, I don't either. But think about it. I read the book. I didn't see the movie. But think
it
about it.
It was in the book.
I don't remember. But think about it. You have a ton of athletes from different countries on different teams. They have to stay somewhere, right?
No, I'm not saying that. Yeah, but where? What I'm asking is where do they stay? Like, where is this place?
I don't know.
Is it a hidden?
They build like a little city.
They actually build something?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
In whatever location they have in...
Yes, they do.
No shit.
Yep.
They're also saying that the beds that they're provided only fit one person and it's a problem. Mm. The Olympians are pissed.
See, that's why they do it outside.
All of us go through that.
Yeah, that's fucking college right there. Yep. That's 4 years of college.
Yep. So I think that's interesting. You know, I thought that professional athletes were told, like, you know, to not have sex before an event.
They're probably supposed to keep it discreet.
There's the hottie.
I saw a picture of him winking and pointing at the camera. It's like the fucking sexiest thing
he's
I've ever
gorgeous.
Seen.
He's really gorgeous. He's going to get so much fucking tail.
Apparently he's really cocky.
I'm sure he's got a big
even
cock.
Hotter.
Man with hand in pocket feel cocky all day.
Oh, man. I'm going to do one more thing. True that, Jake. A man's penis was stolen by thieves.
This one I actually fucking read this
yeah.
one.
His name is Phi.
This story is fucking ridiculous.
Phi Lin.
Oh, no, the Chinese.
In China.
Yeah, of course.
He told police he was asleep when the thieves burst into his room and put a bag over his head. And they pulled down my trousers and then they ran off. I was so shocked, I didn't feel a thing. Then I saw I was bleeding and my penis was gone. You know that song, Detachable Penis?
I love that song. The best is the reason that they took it.
Police believe the attackers were jealous lovers of several local women whom Lin was having affairs with.
This guy was banging mad chicks and got his dick stolen.
Lin denied taking part in any infidelity. Emergency workers and police searched for Lin's anatomy but turned up nothing. The penis thieves are nowhere to be found, but police said they're looking for the jealous lovers.
What do you even do?
He's 41, and honestly, he's really not attractive.
At all.
No.
I just like that he used the word trousers.
I would immediately commit suicide. How do you live without a penis?
Well, your penis is half dead anyway. I mean, it's all mangled.
Yeah. Maybe half dead to you.
Yours came back to life from the dead.
Yes, it did.
It's risen since you.
It's like a zombie.
From the ashes.
It's
like
risen
a phoenix.
Since this episode started.
Yeah.
Yes, it
is. It's hitting the bottom of the table right now.
Why is Molly doing it for you? Yeah, well, I think Molly has shunned you for life.
The show in love with
because you hate women.
Well,
you
Molly,
hate women and you masturbate with pasta.
Molly's more my type than you, honey bun.
I know. She's a brunette.
She is a brunette. And she's got the wavy hair. I kind of dig it.
I know. That's the problem, bringing a woman in here, Jeff.
I know.
I'm putting the smooth moves.
Blame me.
So we're going to end this show soon. Does anyone have anything to add? You suck dick.
There we go.
How was your first show?
This was fucking awesome.
Okay. Do you have any Let's see. What can we ask her?
Okay, I'm trying not to pull a Kelly Rose right now and run out to the bathroom.
I know, you have to pee really bad. Well, that's what happens. We down all the alcohol.
I chugged two beers during the episode.
All right, we'll end the show so you can urinate. And
thank
not,
you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
See you guys next time.
Hear that, fans? You're getting less show.
Oh.
I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
He's such a dick.
All right, suck. Fucking hit me.
No. All right, we'll see you next week.
Peace out.